let us stand on our feet as our honoree is now coming out. Bishop Wilbert L. Daniel, senior pastor of the St. Paul Church of God in Christ. The second ecclesiastical jurisdiction, state of Virginia. God bless you. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you for this opportunity. You allowed us to come and to celebrate our bishop in this community. We pray that you continue to bless our bishop and this community. Lead us and guide us according to thy will and way and thy purpose. This is our prayer. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirt of his garment. We thank the Lord for the reading of these words, sanctify his truth, deep down our heart. Let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I know it's hot out here, and so I guess we're on our way to make heaven our home. Because we do not want to experience this, do we? Amen. Praise God. As we get ready to move forward in this celebration, I just want to thank God for all the officials that have made it out here on today.
Amen.
Amen. To our state of Virginia Senator Lionel Spruill.
Amen.
To Mayor Alexander and his representative.
Amen.
And all the city council representatives. Also, we want to thank God for our jurisdictional supervisor being here on today, Mother Holmes. Amen. And we thank God for all the administrative staff of this jurisdiction and the good old St. Paul Church of God in Christ. That's the reason why we're here. Amen. Amen. So on today here, as we are here to celebrate a man of God who founded Christ at the center of his life 67 years ago. This man we know today is the son of a church.
Yes.
He sat under the tutelage of his mentor and pastor, the late Bishop D. Lawrence Williams. Because of his faithfulness to Bishop Williams and the Mother Church, Mason Memorial, he was sent to St. Paul to check on the work. A smaller congregation and building, he was often reminded that I did not mean for you to stay here, as he had many conversations with Bishop D. Lawrence Williams. However, Bishop Williams relied upon our celebrant on today because of his faithfulness, his dedication, and his love for the church. The man of God who was sent to stay has been here for now for 56 years here at 1615 Isaac Street. But I come to you on today to give you notice that this address will be changed and named in his honor.
Amen.
So let us put our hands together as we celebrate with our leader, who is the head pastor. And he is 89 years old. He's the head pastor of the St. Paul Church of God in Christ.
Yeah.
Amen. Everybody ought to stand and give this man of God his due.
Good afternoon. It is indeed a pleasure to be here and to be a part of this great celebration, this history-making moment. To Mayor Alexander and Councilman Paul Riddick in their absence, to the city officials and all the clergy, and to all of those present. Some have traveled near and far, but we are gathered today to give recognition to our shepherd, our leader, our pastor, and our bishop, Bishop Wilbert L. Daniels, Sr. We've come to give tributes and honor to Bishop Wilbert Daniels for his dedication, his loyalty, his faithfulness, and his reputation. His accomplishments have left an imprint on us and the community and the environment and the world. We have come to rejoice and give thanks. We have come to share this time, and we've come to witness history being made today. And we are all a part of this history. We've come to pay homage. I just want to tell you a little bit about him. He was born in Greensboro, North Carolina, to the late Elroy and Mrs. Arlethea Daniels. He was the fourth of nine children. He received his formal education from Booker T. Washington High School in Norfolk, Virginia. He attended Norfolk State College, Berean Bible College. And in 1953, Bishop Daniels acknowledged his call to the ministry. And on August the 27th, 1958, he was ordained as an elder. Then in July of 1962, Bishop Daniels was appointed to be the pastor of the St. Paul Church of God in Christ. where he is still here, and we are so grateful for that. He is the founder of the Words of Life radio ministry, the television ministry, the jurisdictional prelate of the second ecclesiastic jurisdiction for the state of Virginia. He is our pastor. He is our friend. He has so many accolades and stuff, and I don't even need to tell y'all all of this. The biggest thing about today, I'm so happy, is he is still amongst us. Amen. Most times when these things happen, the person has passed on. We want to honor their history, but I'm just so grateful that he is still a living giant amongst us, and where his words of encouragement are always, be faithful. Be faithful. When things get rough, be faithful. When things get right, be faithful. And his other thing is, with God, all things are possible. So today, as we unveil the street name for this giant of a leader, he is so deserving of this. And we thank you all for coming, and we thank God for him. And I just thank God to be a part of his ministry. And one thing about him, he's the same everywhere you see him. If you're in Texas, Hawaii, or wherever you see him, he is the same. And he has an honorable reputation. If I say, somebody say, what church you go to? Say, oh, Bishop Daniels. Yeah, fine gentleman, fine gentleman. So it gives me great pride to be a part of his leadership, a part of his membership, and I do all I can to help him as he helps us. God bless you.
To the bishop-elect, bring to the presiding elders, superintendent, presiding elders, superintendents who are here today, to superintendent, I believe, supervisor, to all the lecturers, to all ministers, and to all of God's children, good afternoon. I do want to greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and say that how nice and how proud I am to be here today for something that should have been done a long time ago.
Amen.
89 years old, he's still holding on, waiting to see it. So first, I want to bring greetings on behalf of Bishop Daniels, bring greetings on behalf of Mayor Kenneth Alexander. He is getting his doctoral degree today in Tennessee, where I believe in about 45 minutes going there myself. So he wants me to bring greetings on behalf of the mayor of Norfolk. And Bishop Daniels, he wants to make sure that we are naming a street after you, not the whole city. And I got it on my phone. We want to make sure. We want to make sure. So I had to text him back that it's the street, not the city. But nevertheless, Bishop, on behalf of the 5th District, I am so thankful to God that he has allowed you to see this day. I am so thankful that we here now are giving you your roses while you're living. Most of the time, we went to somebody lay across the church and said all them good things about them. They can't hear that one word. So we are doing it while he's still here. Last, I want to say, it should have changed. It shouldn't have been this street. They should have named the whole circle after the bishop for the sermon, the work that he has done. So I'm here first to thank the bishop for all what he has done, to thank his superintendents for all what they have done. Thank all of you for what you have done. Remember that God is still in control. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Giving honor to God, the mothers, elders, family, friends, and guests of St. Paul. I'm Ann Boone. When the call came to me from Sister Porter, Bishop, you know, you never forget me, and I appreciate that. So when the call goes out, and the assignment, and this is my assignment. Thank you for the opportunity to participate in this historic moment. I represent the Berkeley Historical Society, which includes Berkeley and Campus Stella. Each one of us brings to the world unique talents, gifts, and abilities. God gives us all assignments. There are gifts from God, and when we share these gifts, we are sharing God's gifts bestowed for the good of the world. Today, we come to congratulate and celebrate this historic moment and grand occasion. Bishop Daniels has been instrumental in the positive changes and improvements to Campus Stella, to include advocating with the Civic League, community gatherings, and the Aquatic Center right now on Campus Stella Road. And we thank Bishop and St. Paul's Church of God in Christ. As I close, The ancestors left a torch for us to pick up and run. Therefore, I stand here as one. I stand here as one, but I speak for thousands. We are beneficiaries. We are descendants. Thank you, Bishop Daniels.
Good afternoon to everybody. On behalf of Councilman Paul Riddick, we have met for a special purpose today, and that is to honor Bishop Wilbert Daniels Sr., a man whom we esteem and love. This honor is well earned. Bishop Wilbert Daniels has displayed outstanding leadership in the church and in the community. His sincerity and integrity have earned him the respect and admiration of all of us. He has exercised sound judgment and wise counsel. He has rendered faithful service down through the years. I send my warmest congratulations to you, Bishop Daniels. I pray God's continued blessings will be with you, Councilman Paul Riddick.
But now we come into a part of this celebration I know which every one of you have come here on today for. That is for the unveiling of the sign. But before the unveiling of the sign comes, we're going to ask if Elder McClenney would come forth to give us the prayer of dedication. But also, I would like to say, we have many people that are here on today, and some I have not called, but I just want to recognize our administrative assistant, Joseph Williams, for being here on today. Amen. Amen. We also thank God for Superintendent Michael B. Golden, Jr. for being in our presence on today, as well as Bishop Designate Philip Green. God bless you, sir. So at this time, our prayer of dedication is getting ready to come forth. And then right after that will be the opportunity in which we all have come here for. We're going to ask if Minister Shelton Daniels get ready and Sister Brittany Strange get ready after this prayer of dedication as our bishop will come down to see. Let us stand.
Let us stand. And let us bow our head. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we give you thanks, O God, for the gift of your people and the work of many hands, which have beautified this place and furnished it for the celebration of this man of God, Bishop Wilbert Daniels Sr., who has dedicated his life and his service to this community. Accept and bless all he has done and grant that in these earthly things we may behold the order and beauty of things heavenly. Through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Five, four, three, two, one.
God bless and greetings to all of you. All of our city officials have been addressed properly, all of you in your proper positions. This is an exciting moment for me, yet a humble experience. It gives me great pleasure to introduce and to present to you our honoree. He's a proven leader, administrator, innovator, and community ambassador. He has held and holds numerous positions within the national and jurisdictional level of the Churches of God in Christ. On the national level, he was elected as a member of the National Board of Trustees, a member of the General Assembly. He is a member of the Charles Harrison Mason Foundation. In 2012, he was consecrated and inducted into the College of Bishops. In 2015, Bishop Charles Edward Blake appointed him as jurisdictional bishop for the Virginia Second Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. On the jurisdictional level, he has held the following positions: First Administrative Assistant to Bishop Samuel L. Green, Jr., Superintendent of the Berkeley District, Chairman of the Pastors and Elders Council, Chairman of the Ordination Board, President of the Young People Willing Workers, YPWW. He is now presently the President of the Koji High-Rise Apartment. As a community ambassador, he's a lifelong member of the NAACP. He's a former member of the Hampton Roads Rainbow Coalition and a former vice president of the Campostella Civic League. He's a family man. He's married to the lovely missionary Lillian Boyette Daniel. Let's give her a hand. She's here. And together they have raised 9 children who have and do play an active role in the ministry. I would that you will stand with me. All of you, will you stand as I bring to you none other than Bishop Wilbert L. Daniels, Sr., Prelate of the Second Jewish Diction Church of God in Christ, Pastor of the St. Paul Church of God in Christ. Yeah. Bishop Daniels.
You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you.
That's my granddad.
I'm overwhelmed with your generosity. I don't have words in my vocabulary to express my gratitude to what's taking place to the city of Norfolk and to all of guests here on this platform, to the Second Jewish Diction, to St. Paul family, where I've been pastoring 56 years,
yes,
and for many families who have been here by my side. I never could have imagined having a street named after me all these many years that I've been here. I certainly want to thank our dear friend and sister. Thank you and the resident of this neighborhood for sticking with me for more than these many years that I've been here. I just don't have words in my vocabulary to express my gratitude to all of you for being here today as we celebrate this occasion. May God bless you forever.